I've experienced what you talk about. I think it's so naive on the part of hospital administrators to do that. When I look at my hospital, and I don't think I'm that far different from many of my competitors, I'm looking at probably 10 to 15% of my admissions coming from four nursing homes that I have a close relationship with. When you look at a hospital, our costs, even more than a nursing home, are so incredibly weighted to the fixed side of the ledger that every additional patient I get gives me a hell of a lot better chance of breaking even or making a profit in New York. So I got to tell you, I mean, part of the reason, I guess, is sometimes there are some hospitals that might have, my hospital has about 350 med-surg beds. We have a relationship with five nursing homes, one of which we own, control, and four others that are in our community. I've seen some of my colleagues who tell me, similar size hospital, that they have a relationship with 30 nursing homes. I would argue with you that a hospital that says that has a relationship with none. It has to be a serious issue. I mean, the nursing homes that I'm dealing with are giving me 150 admissions a year. I'm giving them a similar number. So I think it has to be substantive. And if it's a hospital that you're dealing with that one or two patients a month are going back and forth, that's probably going to be the response. But I wonder in those cases, does the CEO know how much business he's getting from you? And if he doesn't, that's probably a phone call worth making. Because what we look at in the Medicare bill coming is significant reductions, as you do, in terms of what Medicare is going to be paying us. Those of us who take care of a large number of Medicaid are having the disproportionate share funds cut. That while I, as I said, I think it's a great bill because it's covering the uninsured and it's going to be good for our country, it's going to kill an awful lot of hospitals. The hospital administrator, make sure he knows how much business he's getting from you. And I've seen a lot of my colleagues who don't. Now, obviously, we all, and my predecessor as an attorney was talking about malpractice. I'm sure from a conversation of compliance, he would tell you, you know, we don't get involved in things that I'll send you my patients if you send me yours. It's illegal. We wouldn't do that. But what we can do and recognize from a quality perspective is if we have a limited number of relationships that involve a significant number of patients, we have a hell of a lot better chance to coordinate the care between the two facilities. With the administrators at the nursing homes that I deal with, I'm on the phone with each one of them once every week or two. And sometimes it's just BSing or we're going to golf or something like that. But the other times it's we have a patient that's either one of our patients developed a problem in their nursing home or one of their patients developed a problem in my hospital, and we can address it so that we don't have to get to that malpractice case later on. So I think make sure the administrator knows and find that way. And in this day and age, you know, I would say concentrate as you can. Don't try to have an array of 100 hospitals that you have the relationships with, because it's probably not even worth your effort. If you can find the 4, 5, 6, depending on the size of your place, depending on your location, and develop the heck out of those relationships, I think then you're not going to be dealing with the junior assistant or whatever, and the CEO, if she or he has any brains, is going to be getting back to you real quickly, because you're more important to them than probably all but 3 or 4 of their leading physicians. Sure. Well, it hasn't happened yet, but the idea behind it is that the feds are going to come to an organization, and again, it's the Center for Medicare and Medicaid Innovation, and an organization is going to come in, and let's say here, we're in New York City, so I'll say I'm the head of Columbia Presbyterian, has like 8 hospitals, 1 million doctors, whatever, all, you know, all around the metropolitan area, and I'll go to the feds and say, listen, I'm going to take care of this population of Medicare patients for you. They're receiving their primary care from these 73 doctors who I control, and there's a population of 10,000. And I want you to pay me 95% of Medicare's annual expenditures for their total care. And you leave it up to me to provide that care. So I, in some ways, take the position of the Medicare HMOs. I get all that money, and it's going to be probably and mainly initially in hospital group in hospitals or physician groups. And I take all the money in, and then I sit down with you and say, listen, if you want the nursing home days for my patients, here's what I expect from you. In terms of, now, the short-sighted way of doing that is me going and saying, I want a 20% discount on the per diem. I think most places are going to be smart enough to say, that's chump change compared to what I can get if we work together and cut the length of stay and cut the readmission rates. But it's basically a hospital, a group of physicians. I don't know if a nursing home can be the prime mover on it. I don't think they can, but I'm not certain. Gets a capitated payment for a defined group of patients who it then provides all the care for, or either directly or through contract. Yep.
Is there any mention in the act about QIOs getting involved in helping the transition? Is there any mention in the act about QIOs, quality improvement organizations? You're not familiar with the quality improvement organization?
About quality improvement organizations?
Yeah. Is there any mention in the act?
Well, everything it talks about in the act is basically it wants to reduce costs, improve quality, and improve access. So it wants to be, you know, motherhood and apple pie for everyone there. And it.
Okay. So, in that regard, is there any mention of the quality improvement organizations that Medicare requires each state a contract with, helping bridge the gaps between the hospitals and the nursing facilities?
I can't say that there isn't any, but if it is, it's rather minor, and it's in the footnotes.